there is considerable jargon in the beekeeping world, right? When you get into beekeeping, you hear words you've never heard before. Well, one phrase that's definitely beekeeping jargon is the phrase brood pattern. What is a brood pattern? Why do we care? Why do beekeepers seem to be talking about it all the time? Well, a brood pattern, like the name implies, is the pattern or the array of brood, the age of brood, and the dispersal of brood around a comb. What does all of this mean? Well, let's start with a queen. A queen goes to an empty comb and often starts laying eggs in the very center of that comb, and she has a spiral egg-laying pattern all the way to the periphery of that comb. Because of that, cells that are adjacent to one another often contain developmental stages of bees that are roughly the same age, right? The queen is just laying eggs in neighboring cells, so as a result, those eggs are going to progress through the developmental stages similarly. And when you extrapolate that to an entire frame, a queen can lay an entire face of a comb in less than a day, or maybe a day or 2 days. That means all of the individuals developing in that comb are roughly the same age. So you'll get the egg stage and the larval stage, the pupal stage, and then they'll all emerge as adults. Since queens typically begin laying in the center and spiral out, that center patch of brood will tend to emerge first, so the queen will come back and start laying eggs in it as that brood begins to emerge away from that patch of eggs, and then the queen spirals out to follow that emerging brood. Because those individuals in neighboring cells are roughly the same age, and because all of the individuals on a comb are roughly the same age, usually within a couple of days, you can determine the pattern once all the individuals become capped. So we know that bees will cap over larvae after they finished eating. The larvae will stand up in their cells and become what we call prepupae. They're technically larvae, but it's the stage right before the pupal stage. They shed their larval skin and become pupae that then develop to the point where they shed their skin and become adults that emerge from the cells. Now, I'm overgeneralizing here, but because the brood is roughly the same age, once the workers begin capping brood on a frame, within a day or two, most of that brood would be capped. And again, biology's messy. You're going to get scatterlings of different ages of brood. Maybe the queen came back late to this frame. Of course, all of that's true. But in general, once brood starts getting capped, within a few days, that entire frame will be capped. When the frame is capped, you can judge the brood pattern. Beekeepers tend to have this sliding scale between spotty brood pattern and solid brood pattern. So spotty, moderate, and solid. A solid brood pattern simply means that there are not many empty cells interspersed amongst the capped brood. Now, that doesn't mean the frame is entirely solid, and let me explain that in detail. Essentially, when you're judging the brood pattern, you are looking only at where the brood is. So if the brood covers the entire frame, you're looking at the pattern across the frame. But if the patch is only this large, then you're judging the pattern where there is brood. So I don't hold it against a queen that there's a solid patch of brood here, but there's nothing around it. That's not a spotty brood pattern. A spotty brood pattern is if within that patch, where there's all capped brood, there's a great number of cells that are empty or cells that have grossly different developmental life stages. What do I mean by grossly different developmental life stages? Well, if you've got a lot of capped cells, you would expect them all to be prepupae or pupae, but you might have prepupae and very young larvae or eggs interspersed haphazardly amongst that capped brood. So when beekeepers think about brood patterns, they typically think about solid patterns, moderately spotty patterns, or spotty patterns. When beekeepers use those terms, they're referring to what percentage, roughly, of the cells within the brood pattern actually contain brood. So, as an example, look at this particular pattern. We call this a solid pattern. That's because when you look at where the brood is, less than somewhere in the neighborhood of about 5% of the cells are empty. So 95% of the cells or more contain brood. In this next image, we'll see a moderately spotty pattern. Again, think about where the brood is. The brood doesn't have to cover the entire frame, but where there's brood, what percentage of those cells contain brood versus what percentage of those cells don't contain brood. And in a moderately spotty pattern, somewhere in the neighborhood of 60 to 90% of the cells will contain brood, but the other percent will be empty. When beekeepers think about spotty patterns, where the brood is, when you think about that area where the brood is, 50% or more of those cells will actually be empty. So the way that I think about it is I try to mentally draw a circle or an oval around the brood pattern and do a just rough visual estimate of what percentage of those cells are empty, and then I classify it as solid, moderately spotty, or spotty. And this really helps me have a good indication of the quality of the colony, the quality of the queen, the disease and pest presence in the nest. What does all of this mean? Why would you have solid patterns and moderately spotty patterns and spotty patterns? Well, a lot can make a pattern spotty. Diseases can make patterns spotty. Maybe your queen is laying every cell on that comb, but then as those individuals are developing, they die from chalk brood or American foul brood or European foul brood. Maybe it's a pest. Maybe varroa have moved into those cells and they're killing the developmental stages of brood. Maybe it's a good thing. Maybe your colony has enhanced hygienic behavior and they can detect diseased brood underneath those cappings and they'll open that capping and abort the brood. Many different things can lead to spotty patterns. On top of all of those, nutrition, temperature, all of these things, a lot of times spotty patterns are laid at the feet of the queen. People will always judge the queen quality based on how solid or spotty her pattern is. And recent research has shown that that can't always be assumed. There's a really great study out there that has shown if you move queens from colonies where their patterns are solid and queens that are in colonies where their patterns are spotty to the other queen's colony, the one that formerly had a spotty pattern will now lay a solid pattern. The one that formerly had a solid pattern may now lay a spotty pattern. So spotty brood patterns are not always indications of problems with the queen. But as beekeepers, we want solid patterns. We want evidence that the nutrition's good, that the disease and pest pressures are low, and that the queen is doing well. That's why you tend to hear beekeepers judging the condition of the hive based on the pattern of brood in the nest. As beekeepers, we should always be working towards solid brood patterns. I'm not saying there should be wall-to-wall brood year-round. I'm simply saying where there is brood, it should be solid. If I see spotty patterns in the colony, I start going through my mental checklist. Is there an unchecked disease? Is there an unchecked pest in my colony? Is there evidence of nutritional deficiencies? Has there been a pesticide exposure? Is the temperature cool at nighttime and the bees can't tend the brood? If I go through all of those and rule those out, then I'll start looking at the queen. Is she laying many eggs? Is she producing bees that are really productive and healthy? If all of these things check out, then I might requeen the colony anyway to see if that fixes it. But if I can narrow it down to nutrition or disease or pest, then I try to address those issues that are the root cause of the spotty pattern. One final word of caution. Sometimes new queens can move into a colony and start off with a spotty pattern. I'm essentially telling you that spotty patterns can occasionally remedy themselves. The queens may get better over time as they're settling in to their egg-laying duties. I simply wanted to make you aware, as a beekeeper, we should be working towards solid patterns. We should try to identify what may be the root cause of spotty patterns, and then we need to be able to remedy that situation to keep our colonies as strong and as healthy and as productive as possible. Thank you.